Namaste. In the previous video, we studied the anatomy and physiology of the structures that are involved in pulse diagnosis. Ayurveda too has an elaborated explanation about these structures. Our understanding of Hridaya comes from looking at the physiological process that happens in the body. Why is Hridaya one of the three marmas and what's so important about it? We shall now proceed with some relevant references of the anatomy of Hridaya, which is one among the three marmas. This sloka explains the swarupa of Hridaya. The Hridaya is being compared to that of a downward facing Kundalika, which means the lotus. Just imagine the external structure of the heart. The apex points downwards, right? The simile used here sounds certainly apt when we recall how the heart looks. The verse also explains that the heart is more active when the person is in an awakened state and is less active when one is asleep. Another aspect that needs to be mentioned here is that Hridaya is the adhishtana for Anahata Chakra, which is represented by a lotus having 12 petals. Also, we can correlate the Sushumna Nadi to be having the structure of the stem of the Pundarika or the lotus. Do you think all these are just a coincidence? According to this verse, Hridaya originates from Kapha and Raktha. Hridaya is a seat for Dhamanis. The location of the Hridaya is being conveyed grossly by mentioning the relations of the organs, that is, on the left of the heart lies Spleha and Pupusa, and on the right side lies the Yakut and the Cloma. This particular verse says that there are mainly 10 vessels of great biological importance attached to the heart. The words Mahat and Artha are used as synonyms of the heart, indicating the significance of Hridaya. In this verse, the relationship and connection between a wheel and its spokes has been used as a simile to depict the relationship between Hridaya and the dasha dhamanis, pranavata, apanavata, mana, buddhi, chetana and the mahabhutas. A deeper understanding of this metaphor will give us an idea that circulation is a cyclic process. Keep in mind the following facts. Hridaya is in direct relationship with pranavata, vyanavata, sadaka pitta, avalambaka kapha, and indirectly in relationship with all the entities in the sharira. After learning about Hridaya, it is now essential for us to know about the blood and its references in Ayurveda. The Hridaya and the different vessels attached to the Hridaya carry four vital entities. They are Rasa, Rakta, Ojas and Prana. Rasa is the entity metabolized from the Ahara Rasa or food which nourishes all the tissues. Rakta is the red fraction which is formed by the action of Ranjaka Pitta on Rasa in Yakrit and Pliha, which does the function of enlivening. Ojas is the ultimate product formed by virtue of good quality tissues in the body and is responsible for major functions like immunity. Finally, Prana is the fraction derived from respiration and maintains the proper physiology of the body. We have been continuously seeing that Dhamanis arise from Hridaya and that Dhamanis have its root in Hridaya. Let us learn about it as it is relevant from the point of view of Nadi Vijnana. But we will learn about Dhamani by understanding Sira and Srotas simultaneously. The sloka for its definition is as follows. The meaning of this sloka can be explained as Dhamani are the vessels that pulsate on filling and carry the above mentioned entities all over the body. Srotas are the vessels from which the entities can ooze out or diffuse out. Astira are the vessels that carry the entities without pulsating. Did you know that the word Sira is derived from the Vedic term Hira? The term Hira is described as the channel carrying blood towards the Hridaya. This explanation is important because it assumes the presence of three distinct segments in the vascular tree: the pulsating segment, the exchange segment, and the transporting segment. The three structures, even though are structurally different, in several contexts, the words have been used interchangeably. Acharya Sushruta mentions that Dhamanis as nabhi prabhava, meaning that which originates from nabhi, whereas other acharyas opine that Dhamanis originates from Hridaya. The word nabhi prabhava can be accepted in relation to fetal life because during intrauterine life, the vessels like umbilical artery and the umbilical veins start from the fetal umbilicus. What is the importance of dasha dhamanis which arise from the heart? We all know that ojas is the entity that sustains life. The ojas has to be circulated sarva sharira for the body to sustain. These dasha dhamanis which take their origin from Hridaya carry the ojas and pulsate throughout the body. Chakrapanidatta has added that these dasha dhamanis are responsible for multiple major functions in the body. Acharya Vaghbhata too has explained that the dasha dhamani connected to the Hridaya carry rasa and ojas to different parts of the body. Interestingly, he also described that the blood vessels go on giving branches, and as they do so, they go on becoming narrower and narrower in a fashion similar to that observed in the denation of leaves. In the previous video, we learned how the sympathetic nervous system, parasympathetic nervous system, and the conduction system of the heart, which includes the SI node, AV node, bundle of His, and the Purkinje fibers, control, regulate, and maintain the function of the cardiovascular system. In Ayurveda, Pranavata is known to be responsible for the functioning of Hridaya. The other vata, which plays a major role in circulation, is located in Hridaya. It is the Vyanavata, which is responsible for the pumping action of the heart. In this context, Vyanavayu and Pranavayu denote the nervous control of circulation, because Vayu in general represents all neural mechanisms. Let us now head to the last part of the video, in which the Ayurvedic purview about circulation as a continuum will be studied. This verse, taken from Hela Samhita, clearly states that the blood is first ejected out of the heart. It is then distributed to all parts of the body, and thereafter it returns back to the heart through the blood vessels known as Sira. This proves that thousands of years ago, Indian scientists were aware that the circulation is a closed cyclic process. Sticking to our main topic of Nadi Vijnana, we understood that arterial pulse has been depicted in different parts of our text. Acharya Charaka has mentioned it as Sparsha Vijnana. We already looked into the importance of Hridaya as the ashraya for rasa and ojas, and how it pumps these entities to all parts of the body. We also learned how the dhamanis carry these entities, and their movement causes dhvana or spandana. This spandana proved the presence of jiva. The spandana also represents the various gunas carried by rasa and other entities in the sharira, thus enabling the Nadi Parikshaka to access the condition of the body. Further information has also been mentioned in later texts like Yogaratnakara Samhita and Charangadhara Samhita. Let us now try to summarize the contents of this video in brief. We tried to explain the structure of Hridaya followed by its importance. We learned how to take into consideration blood from the purview of Ayurveda. We looked into the various vessels that are present in the body and also learned the importance of dhamanis. Following this, we studied how the circulatory system functions and how it is regulated. We also understood how Ayurveda has explained the circulation in a closed circuit thousands of years before William Harvey discovered the heart. Finally, we learned that Ayurveda has explained pulse, examination and diagnostic principles in a detailed manner, which we will be pondering upon in further videos. Take a moment and try to understand circulation according to Ayurveda from this flowchart. Thank you for your patience. If you like this video, hit the like button and consider subscribing to our channel. Share with your friends and follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more updates.